Hello again. Not so long ago, Sony released the firmware 3.0, and that was well expected by us and well deserved. It got some improvements, like with 4K DCI and 24p, changing the menus, and you know, some sort of a wireless protocol, but also introduced a big issue with the raw signal. In terms that if you have an Atomos Ninja recorder and you obviously try to output raw from the Sony A7S III, the image was, as you remember, 3 times brighter. And let me spin you around and just remind you what was the issue. So at the moment, if we are looking into the camera menu here on my Sony A7S III, it is clearly that, you know, we have to go into some sort of a convoluted algorithm to realize that actually we are shooting in a picture profile 8 and we are at 25 frames per second XAVCI. And that's not a problem. Everything looks nice and dandy. Remember that if we are using the Lachman scale, which is simply shows us based on the camera model and the gamma curve and gamut, which is Sony S-Log3 S-Gamma3 Cine, as you can see here. If you are using the Lachman scale, this is a very objective and well-designed type of false color display that will basically show us how many stops we have above and below middle gray. And this is the image that we are welcome. And you may stop the video and realize, and you can, that we are basically in a very high dynamic range scene that goes from -5 to, I would say, +3 in terms of dynamic range. So it's fairly quite big dynamic range scene. Now, if we are going to go into the menu of the camera and quickly turning here the output raw on, camera will reboot, which is normal. It's, as you can see, it takes a while for the camera and the device, Atomos Ninja, to negotiate the signal. And now we are know for sure that we are recording in ProRes RAW. Camera is outputting a RAW signal, as you can see here. So all is fine. But for the exact same scene and exact same light conditions, if we are going now back to Lachman scale, which to confirm is this one, L zone, as you can see, the image, it looks completely different. So the brightest tone is 5 stops or almost 6 stops above middle gray. And obviously the darkest tone is somewhere at -4. And this is obviously a mismatch, because if I did not change any settings in the camera, I'm still at the ISO 640 and at 5.6 1 over 50th of a second. So I simply, what I did, as you can, you also saw, I basically changed the output to RAW. That's all I did, and the levels are wrong. Now, with the new firmware update, they promised that they have changed that. So let's see how exactly we can install the firmware update, and then live we will demonstrate if this hypothesis is true or not. So now I'm in front of my computer and I have downloaded the new update. And obviously you are welcome with 2 firmwares. One is 2.15 and the other one is 3.01. So your camera needs to be at least of the firmware or version 2.15 in order to update it. And my camera is firmware 3.0, so I can skip this step. All I can need to do is to simply double click the executable file and the software will do its job to extract the files and prepare the firmware installation. Now it tells you very simple that you have to connect the camera to the computer. Now, as you can see, I have the camera. I'm going to connect it now to the computer through the USB-C cable. And what you want to see is that USB mode needs to be selected mass storage. Now, once that has been done, you also have to make sure that your battery is at least maybe 50%. In the manual says should be 100, but probably 50% will work as well. So further, we simply press next, and the version will be checked, and then next, and now obviously we have to wait for the firmware to be installed. Again, you can listen to Smashing Pumpkins' Everlasting Gaze or whatever song you want. Probably you have to listen maybe 2-3 times and everything will be done. So we'll see you shortly. Right, now that the update process is complete and the camera is restarted, let's see what actually is happening. So, if I'm going into the menu, for example, but we're going to turn this off, I would say that let's check the version first. And the version says 3.01. So that's good. So we are in the correct version. Now, if we go back into the menu, we can see that again we are in XAVCI 4K picture profile 8. And further, what else we can check is the fact that for the moment we are not uploading RAW. So if we go to HDMI settings, RAW output is off. That's fine. So this is the image that I have in front of me. And we can check again that the camera is set to S-Log3 S-Gamma 3 Cine, as it should. And if we check the Lachman scale and we confirm, we have a dynamic range between, I would say, minus 5 to plus 3 stops of light. Hello there. Now, I will show you also from this angle, reason being, this when I'm recording with the Atomos Ninja, you won't be able to see the false color scale. So as you can see, again, the scene ranges from minus 5 to plus 3. Now, this is the moment of truth. If we go out of here and we go into the menu and it HDMI's output settings, we set the RAW output to on, the camera will obviously reboot. We accept here and here. That's normal for the camera to reboot. And we have to make sure that we are recording in ProRes RAW. And now, if we are going to the Lachman scale, it's the same. Yep, they have, I would say that they corrected it. Again, the signal is from minus 5 to plus 3. It took me a while to realize that. And out of the bat, what I can see, it's obviously there is much more noise in the image. But I would say that at some extent, this is acceptable. So obviously, a RAW file will be much more noisier than an S-Log file, a shot at base ISO. But I would say that I'm quite happy with the results. They changed everything. And if you remember the previous settings, okay, we can check again. We go to output off and we come at RAW off. We're coming out from the menu and we simply have to make sure that HDR it's activated. And yeah, it is absolutely the same exposure. This time there are no mismatch values. We have the same scene from minus 5 to plus 3. Everything looks in order. So I'm happy to confirm that with this update the camera is working as it should. Now we can take advantage of 4K 24p DSI. We can take advantage of the new menu system. And when you are outputting RAW through Atomos Ninja, any version, there is absolutely no mismatch. So very happy with the results and happy shooting. See you all in the next one.